Okay. So let's start our session today with Shikehiro Yoshi to talk about the remaining part of this talk, which is about exotic states, XYZ, and maybe some application in hand research. So let's begin the section.
Y when the JPC quantum number is 1 minus minus. This is a test for me. And as I said, it is electrically charged before this. However, unfortunately, in a particle data group, they just call X. All X, Y, Z are X in the particle data group. So you have to be a little bit careful when you see that you want to find something in the particle data group. Anyway, the important question is, what are the structures of X, Y, Z? And this is essentially related to the non-particle dynamics of QCD. And so there are several candidates. The first candidate is a compact multiple, where, for example, in this case, CC bar, UD bar, O are confined in a small spatial region. There is also picture like a hadronic model. In this case, the effective degrees of freedom are D and D bar. That means the CD bar fork and the C bar fork is separate each other. And they make a molecule-like state. And there's also a picture about the glucosonic excitation mode. In this case, the string tension between CC bar makes some vibration and they make a string excitation whose quantum numbers are called sigma pi delta pi, corresponding to so-called SPDF in our conventional atomic physics. So, okay. And there is also recently new ideas about this XYZ. And some people say that XYZ are not a real particle. They are just some kinematical effect, like Kasky effect. In this case, XYZ appears around the threshold, and there is no, this is not a reference. But anyway, keeping those pictures in mind, I'd like to see what kind of particles are discussed. And first of all, I'd like to talk about the term tetrapod. In this case, the flavor has the term, and the core component is a tetrapod. The first example is a famous X-87 field. Indeed, this is the first exotic hadrons which have been discovered in this heavy flavor. And this is a first paper by Bell Group in 2003, and by measuring the decay of B to J psi pi plus pi minus. Then, by investigating the invariant mass, they found some peak around here, which is whose mass is 37 MeV. But this state was a little bit curious, in a sense that in a naive Koch model, we have, this is our conventional Koch model picture, and here we have the beta C and J psi, which we have introduced yesterday, and I think the black lines are experimental data, and the blue dotted lines are theoretical prediction. And here we can find the H-72. But this is a little bit different from the conventional Koch model right here. The 100 MeV or 80 MeV, the 80 MeV difference here. And surprising fact is that the mass of H-72 is very close to the D0 star bar threshold. Indeed, the threshold mass of D0 star bar is 3072.68 plus minus 0.10 MeV, and the observed mass of H-72 is 3071 plus 69 plus minus 0.17 MeV. So in that sense, within the errors, we cannot distinguish those two things. And we may ask, what is the quantum number of XYZ? And this was analyzed by here in the Bell and Babar. And they measured the photon decay from X-3072 J psi gamma. And as we have seen, the J psi parity is C equal minus, which is the vibration energy. And as well, the gamma also the charge parity, C charge symmetry is equal to minus 1. Therefore, multiply this minus 1 and minus 1 plus. Therefore, the charge C parity of this charge 2 is plus 1. And there, after the distribution of the DGA product was analyzed to look for the spin of this thing. And there is several works, but I'd like to hear more the work by LCB, because this is the paper which actually identified the quantum number of X subject 72. And they actually analyzed the angular distribution like X side 5 plus 5 pi minus and 5 plus pi minus 5 0. And before this LCB paper, there was two candidates of plus plus or two minus plus. But at the end, we found that JPC is actually 1 plus plus. So this is our answer for this question. And the property of the X72 is interesting in the sense that the decay to the D0-D0 star bus threshold is much enhanced to the J-side decay. For example, this data shows that the branching ratio of the decay on X32 to open threshold, open DD pair is much larger than the decay to J side. So 10 times larger. So this indicates that X32 must contain much component of DD bar component in this. So our naive interpretation of this X32 is could be a molecular state, because this mass is very close to D0D0 bar, and actually the energy difference from the threshold is less than 0.1. However, when we adopt this kind of naive representation, we have to face some problem, because due to this small binding, small mass difference, we have to have this kind of picture that the scale or size of this molecule should be larger than 10 femtometer. This 10 femtometer is much larger in the sense that this size is comparable to the nucleus size of B. However, the problem is that if this is really such an extended state, this is much pleasurable particle and should be and cannot explain the production rate in the PV bubble region. So that was the problem. And there have been some efforts to solve this this inconsistency about the production. And one answer could be here. So, as I said, simple DD bar molecules still is not working. And the hint can be seen in the absence of high C1-2B. So, yesterday also discussed about this high C1B, and do you remember the quantum number of this high C1? So, it was 1 plus plus. And this 2B means the excitation. So, principal value. Principal number is 2, but still it is PV. So this quantum number, Xc1, is the same with X32, because as I have said, LHCB identified the JPC is 1 plus plus for X32. And the idea is that this no observation of Xc1-2B, actually, many experimenters have been have searched about this state, but they didn't find, could be explained by the mixing effect between DD bar and the high C1. Actually, this could be the case, because DD bar and the high C1 couple each other in the S wave. So there is no centrifugal barrier which disturbs the coupling. Therefore, this coupling between DD bar and the high C1 should be very strong. And based on this picture, some model calculation has been performed by those people, and there are really some similarities. So first, we set the wave function as a superposition of D0D0 star bar and the charged D state and CC bar. And this CC bar means the pi C1 to P C. And we introduced in the Hamiltonian way coupling between the D0D0 bar and CC bar four state. And this is just a model setting, but we can show that this is gives a reasonable result. And here the G, the coupling constant lambda, is part of parameter in momentum space, which corresponds to the size of the system. And then we give the Hamiltonian H, whose component is the diagonal part is the J, chi C1 to B mass, and the D0 star mass and the Heimlich term, and the charge state mass and the Heimlich term. And in the off diagonal part, we have this kind of mixing shape here and here. And those parameters are determined to reproduce the mass D2. And the cutoff parameter was ranging from 0.3 to 1.0 GeV, and the corresponding coupling is And when we look at the wave function, so we have the Hamiltonian, therefore, once we diagonalize, we can get the answer. And then the result is something like this. So this C1, C2, C3 is a coefficient of each component. And when we look at the largeness of this component, we find that C2 is indeed the largest number. Therefore, we can say that this system is dominated by the D0 star bar. And actually, this fraction does not strongly happen, does not strongly depend on the cutoff lambda, although lambda is going from 0.3 to 1.0 GeV. And the obtained wave function is something like this. So charged state is somehow obtained by the dotted line, but the D0 star bar is a dominant component at the large distance. And therefore, we can find that this is a very shallow bound state for D0 star bar. But as I have said, what is important in this model is about the mixture effect of chi C1 to B. And this component can be analyzed more clearly in terms of spectral function. And this spectral function measures how much CC bar component could be contained, at least in the, especially in the function of energy. And the result is something like this. So this is the energy and this is the spectral function, and we find the peak of X-72. And in this model, we introduce a CC bar peak around here, but eventually this peak disappears due to the coupling to the X-72, and we only see the broad peak from here. And this somehow explains naturally that we cannot confirm, find the chi C1 to B in our experiment. So this is one story for one candidate. And to see more closely internal structure, the gamma or radiative decay is one of the useful tools. So as I have said yesterday, in the Hadron spectroscopy, we have three keywords, production and mass and decay. And here they consider the decay. And here there are several measurements about the branching ratio, about the decay to psi to S gamma and J psi gamma. And here is the ratio. And the same quantities are measured in Babar, Bell, and NCD. And the result is something like this. Anyway, from this data, we can roughly say that the decay to size to this gamma is 3 times larger than the decay to G psi gamma. And the problem is that our previous model with C bar 4 and DD bar here could explain this factor 3. And the same group have analyzed this decay risk in terms of their model. And they found that the R gamma ratio doing like this is 3.6, 1.8, or 1.0, depending on the coupling to the C bar from P and the DD bar. Sorry, this is not the coupling. Sorry, I didn't talk about this. But anyway, they have found some reasonable value which is consistent with the experimental data. So in this case, this admixture of this C1 to P and D0 star bar to P1 of the good candidate. The next is the 40 by 60. And this is also the same figure of the opening structure. And here we see the 1s state, and here the 2s state, 3s state, and 4s state. And there is a clear gap between 1s, 2s, 3s, and 4s. However, the experiment said that there is a new state between the 3 state and 3s and 4s. And this in the quantum number from minus minus. And this quantum number is clearly identified because the experimental data was analyzed in this kind of process, interstellar. In this case, the T plus T minus bright at the third point and decay to gamma star and this decay to CC bar. Because this gamma is a 1 minus minus state, therefore we can identify this is a 1 minus minus state. And actually, they measured this pi plus pi minus decay, and this is the experimental data. This figure is quoted from the very good. And here we can see here is the peak of Y40 to 60. So the mystery here is what is Y40 to 60? Because already the normal physical picture occupied already in the 3s and the 4s. Therefore, we have to include what we have to consider some additional degrees of freedom. And the one candidate is so called hybrid state. And this is the kind of Brunonic excitation state. So let's see step by step. So this is in the Koch potential. And normally we have this straight line. This is straight in the sense that we at the large distance, we have only linear confinement potential. And this is the potential normally in the CC bar picture. However, there is an excitation of this kind of thing, gluon excitation, and we have also another potential. And indeed, several works have been done so far about the spectrum by using this string-like potential. And there is some candidate of the gluon excited state. This. And recently, Rambira and their collaborators have detailed analysis about this hybrid state. And they somehow identified Y4260 here is some excited state, which they call H1, whose gluon excitation is given by sigma minus and pi. So this is an interesting candidate for the internal structure of the gluon degrees of freedom in the core and in the other. And yet another interesting pathology is GC3900. And this is interesting in the sense that this is actually charged. Therefore, this should not be conventional CC bar. And this is the experimental data from there. and the major j psi pi k, and because j psi pi plus, this pi plus is a charge, therefore we can easily identify this is a really charged state here. So it, as I have said, because this is a charge, we have to at least four poles here. So this is a first, not really first, a good candidate of tetrapole. And some work has been done for this DC3900, and here I'd like to show you some results about QCD, that's QCD calculation, which has been done by Ikeda in Japan. And actually, they measured scattering between C by U, C by U meson, and C D by meson, and they included several coupled channel problems between E star bar and the rho is the scattering size of psi. And then, let me just keep this a little bit detailed. Then find on the lattice calculation some scattering amplitudes, and they analyze the pole of the S matrix. However, unfortunately, the poles they have found in their study is a little bit far from the real axis. Therefore, this should not be counted for the real resonance. Nevertheless, they can explain the experimental data very well, and this, those data are here, and the lattice calculation is shown in this pink band, and then we can find somehow the consistency with the experimental data like this. In that sense, this picture of the cuspid lake would be the one of the good explanation for this experiment. And now we go to the bottom tetrapole. And here again, we have found two charged states, but in this case we have two, which is called ZB 10610 and 10650. And this state is very studied very carefully in the Bell group, and the first analysis has the analysis has been done by the decay from the decay the epsilon 5s to epsilon ns 5 plus pi minus, and ns 1 to 3. And here is the experimental data. And this is the decay to psi 1s and psi 2s and psi 3s. And in those three analyses, we can clearly identify two peaks around here, and the quantum number was analyzed, and as a result, they found that JP equals 1 plus is much bigger than the 2 plus. And surprisingly, this analysis has been done also in other channels, like HB MP with M equal 1, 2, that means HB 1P and HB 2P. And importantly, they found also identified the same structure, same peak, at the same position. Therefore, we can say that this is really existing particle, in the sense we could find in many channels. And the interesting property of this DB are that they are very close to the B star bar threshold. Indeed, the resonance energy is somehow very close to the threshold of B star bar and B star bar. In that sense, the natural explanation is the hadronic molecule state. But before going to the detailed analysis, we may ask something. The first is the various isotope pattern of GP. Because this, if this is a charged state, then this should be isotope 1. And then isotope 0 component should exist somewhere. And how the molecule picture working then? This is the question. And the isotope partner was researched in the, this is also very good, and they did a very detailed analysis. In this case, they used the pi 0 and pi 0. In the previous analysis, they used the pi plus and pi minus. But in this case, the pi 0. In this sense, we can search the neutral state. And they found the B of ZB 1610 here, here, here for psi 1 s, psi 2 s, and psi 2 s. And because the chart, because the phi 0 has the phi 0 has the parity JPC 0 minus plus and epsilon is the 1 minus minus. Therefore, by multiplying this C equal minus, C equal plus, we can identify the C parity of GB 0 is 1 minus 1. So this is the confirmation, or this is the result. However, unfortunately, they cannot find the GB neutral component in the for the another particle 1610650. So this cannot be confirmed. But I think increasing the statistical statistics, I believe they could identify the neutral state. And how does the molecule state is working on this state? And there is some, not the evidence, some suggestions from Spain that the molecule picture could be a good picture. Because this is also there, has analyzed the decay to dB star pi decay, and this is the B star pi. And they found the peak again, dB 10,610 here, and GB 10,650 here. So in this sense, it seems they contain much abundance of dB star bar or B star B star bar component. And indeed, more detailed analysis has been done by looking at the branching fraction. And here is the decay of branching fractions listed here. And the important thing is that this fraction, B star bar and B star bar, is much larger than the decay to chamberlain state, like epsilon 1s, HB 1b. In that sense, a naive expectation is that there should be a large component of BB star bar or B star B star bar. Of course, this is a very simple picture, and in a sense, this is not a real, I think this is not the final picture, but nevertheless, this is a good study. Therefore, many people have worked about this B-star bar picture. And the first work has been done, this is by Bondar's group and Borosin. But let me explain our analysis about this molecule. And in this case, we have to consider several threshold, because we have at least four combinations: BB star bar, B star B bar, BB star bar, and BB bar. But this mass, B star B bar, BB star bar, appear the same. And therefore, in terms of the C parity, you can classify that the lowest threshold is something like this, and the next threshold is BB star bar or B star B bar. And the top threshold is B star B star bar. So those are the components which is used in the molecule picture. And here is several components in the B star state, and they are classified according to the JPC. And here is some list. And some contains the P wave, some contains D wave, and F wave, and G wave. And the corresponding state GB is this line, because the quantum number is 1 plus minus. Therefore, let us look at it carefully about this component. So GB has the four components in sense of BB star bar or B star B star bar. And then the Hamiltonian is given by the 4 by 4 matrix. And here is the BB star bar, BB star bar D wave, BB star bar B star B star bar S wave, BB star B star bar D wave. And the potential, to calculate the potential we need some idea from some theoretical framework. And here, I'd like to just say that heavy box symmetry and chiral symmetry is a good starting point. And maybe I have shown this kind of Lagrangian based on the heavy box effective theory, and then actually this is the Lagrangian, the heavy hadron effective theory, and especially for the coupling to the pion. And not only the pion, the coupling to the Rho meson and Omega meson also included in the analysis to be more realistic. Anyway, so this is a little bit of detail, therefore I skip the detail, I come quite a lot to go to some essential points. So as I have said, in this state we have four components, and there are could be two questions. Why do we have to consider the dB star bar and d star bar simultaneously? Because d and d star in a sense different particles, therefore we do not mix each other. It seems so. However, in terms of the heavy box symmetry, it is quite important to think the both bases simultaneously, because the heavy box spin symmetry mixes the dB star bar and d star bar. And this can be checked by direct calculation. And the second question would be, why do we have to consider S wave and D wave simultaneously? So in the non-relativistic sense, we may separate S wave and D wave. They are quantum numbers. However, in the case of this state, there is a time change, which is given by tensor potential. Therefore, tensor potential, because tensor potential mixes the different angular momentum, which is whose angular momentum is different by two, then the S wave and D wave are mixed each other in the, by this tensor potential. And here is a disk of the potential type. And as I have said, we introduced the 4x4 matrix. 4x4 matrix like this. And the inner structure of this 4x4 matrix is something like this. So we can see some tensor coupling denoted by this. And there is also a coupling by the heavy box spin symmetry here and here. Therefore, in this system, the interplay between the heavy box spin symmetry and fine coefficient potential accompanying tensor plays an important role. And especially, tensor potential plays a very strong, very important role, because tensor potential is very strong because due to this behavior under R square near the origin. Anyway, what we have to do here is just solve Schrödinger equation. But in this case, we have to be a little bit careful because our state in a scattering state. Therefore, we have to consider the scattering problem as we have done in the last exercise. And in this case, essentially, we have three channels. Tomorrow, you remember we did the analysis about the two channels, but in reality, we have the three channels. And solve the scattering problem with multiple channels. And analysis is very straightforward. It is essentially the same with what we have done recently. And the result is something like this. So for the different quantum number, JPC, just forget IG. JPC, 0 minus minus 1 plus minus 1 plus plus 1 minus minus 2 plus plus 2 minus minus. Oh, and this is a unit. Then we can find that the several bound state and resonant state could exist in this model. And for example, the experimental state that there is a GB here and another GB here. So this is the experimental data with error bars. And our model says that there is a bound state here and here. So the upper state seems to be very consistent with experimental data. However, this bound state seems a little bit different from the observed state, because the observed state is here in the resonant state. Therefore, I do not want to say is really correct one, but to find two poles near the experimental data is a kind of interesting thing. And by the way, in this figure, we can find several cache buff resonance. So can you identify whether you are close? So the answer is here, 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 here. Unfortunately, they have not been yet found experiments, but I am eager by an interesting report from this case. Anyway, so this is the result. And based on this result, we can analyze about the radiating decay. In this case, the charge, not the charge, IG for zero state has been analyzed. And as I have said, the GP is has the component BP star bar and B star B star bar, but this is not good basis in terms of heavy cosmic symmetry. Because in terms of the heavy box symmetry, we can use the CC bar 0 minus state and CC bar 1 minus state. So our GP is a superposition of two different chamberium. And the decay to the chamberium state has been at least something like this. The decay to, for example, Pi B0 gamma with M1 transition is given by this internal structure of the things. And then we can decompose this CC bar state, and then by comparing some coefficients here and here, we can see that the branching fraction is going to Pi B0, Pi B1, Pi B2 is given by 1 to 3 to 5. And in reality, we have to take into account also the phase space. And by taking this phase space, we find the branching ratio something like this and something like this. And this is a good information for the experimenters. So by looking at this data, we can know about the linear structure of GB state. Okay, so we are now in the Chern-Korff pentacorp. And the Chern-Pentacorp is 43, 80, and 44, 50. And this is has been found in the 2015, and many mass media also reported this discovery, but unfortunately in Japanese mass media didn't tell anything about this. And only the scientific journal has reported on mass data. So this is what they have done. They analyzed the decay of lambda B0 to J psi K minus B. And for this K minus B, they can identify many resonance states. However, the J psi proton is a new thing. And actually, what they have found is that there is a peak, something like this. Our black dotted lines are the experience of the data. And the red one is some simulation charge. And with including some whole structure in the amplitude analysis, they could reproduce the experimental data very well. So this is the way they, how they found this DC. And indeed, without those holes, they get this kind of red simulation, and this is inconsistent with the observed data. In this case, those two states have been identified in this experiment. And as for the quantum numbers, there's a separate candidate. The first is the 3 half minus and half, 5 half plus, and the other is something like this. Anyway, this is not yet confirmed. Anyway, what is important is that the BC should contain at least CC bar UUD. So there is a hidden term, but we have another UUD component. And of course, our important question is to ask what is the structure. And there have been a lot of experimental analysis based on the pentacorp model, like a pop model picture, and the Hadron molecule, and the gas field, and probably other things are going. Let us flash a little bit the pentacorp picture. And indeed, some kind of NCC bar, UUDCC bar state was predicted already in 1992 by Bobby Discraft Coppola in the they are the expert in the spiral model, and they found by doing some analysis, they found some state with this mass, 28 dB. But this is a little bit too light and seems inconsistent with our PC. And the dipole model has been analyzed by my Annie group, And they identify the mass splitting between 5 half and 3 half. 3 half minus will be explained very well in the dipole model picture. And this is the number 600 dB, the mass difference 600 dB, and our experimental data is 70 dB, therefore, we believe that this good picture. The hadronic molecule has been also analyzed. For example, in the 2005, it would have analyzed this kind of D-star bar sigma state channels, and they have found several peaks, but all of them are below the 4 dB. However, our data cutoff is above 4 dB, therefore that is, this seems a little different. And astonishingly, the OSET group in Spain have analyzed these challenges and they already predicted those states. And surprisingly, those states are somehow consistent with the PC. In that sense, this is a good candidate. However, we have to be a little bit careful about the quantum number because their predicted quantum numbers are a little bit different from the experimental data. And the QCD sample has been analyzed. And this appears just immediately after the discovery of FCD. Anyway, they identify there is a 3 half minus state and 5 half plus state here and here, and they claim that this is consistent with the data, and they also predicted the bottom version. And if these loads are found, then this seems very good. And the other is a bus defect, but unfortunately I don't have time to really just show this slide. But anyway, what is important is that the analyze the triangle diagram and show the plot of scattering amplitude, and they could find some peak structure, kind of peak structure, without core. So they claim that this is a kinematic effect. There is no real resonance. And other things are maybe going on. And this is not the end of the story because we have another XRT, so let me crash something. So we have already seen that the charge state 3900, but we have another charge state, something like this, like this, like this, by investing. And recently, this is NCB, have reported the CC bar, this is bar state. And this is surprising thing is that they identified four states simultaneously. So this is maybe a current state or something. Yeah. And more recently, last year, Diesel Group has reported the existence of X5568. This is quite new in that sense that the flavors of hooks are all different. It's B bar, UD bar. And as far as I know, or as far as people know, this is the first candidate that all flavors are different the data for. So the new research is still going on. And here I'd like to say something about the theoretical prediction about double channel data for. And we have seen that the ZC is a ZC bar UD bar, but there is a new prediction about CC U bar D bar. And because there is a double champ here, they call double champ heterocomp, and sometimes denoted by DCC. And this is interesting in the sense of the dipole model picture, because the content of this DCC is DCC, C bar C, UD. And as I have said yesterday, there is a strong interaction in the UD channel as a dipole. And this dipole channel makes the system very stable, and eventually, in some theoretical model-based calculation says there is a binding energy, 8 MeV. And threshold is here, only here. Therefore, this is the real bound state in the sense of strong reduction, and it decays only by weak decay. And we can also think of the hadronic molecule picture, and instead of the dipole, then you can get by using some basis, we can solve the Schrödinger equation and we can find something in. But this calculation is very analogous to the DB, or DB star bar, D star bar. And many examples of something like this. So, hadronic molecule picture is shown here in the bed line, and the S spin 0 and S spin 1 is for the red and blue, And the type of picture is here, and here. In that sense, by looking at some spectrum of the DCC, we may be able to distinguish the tetrahedral of picture and type of picture. And that calculation has been performed recently. And this is the daily potential, but anyway, there is some attraction, but the attraction is a little bit very small, because this is a phase shift of DE star scattering, and actually, this positive sign means that there is attraction, but this is not so attractive enough to make a bound state. Therefore, we have to a little bit wait more detailed study of the analysis. But anyway, this has been done with the large prior mass. Therefore, we may still have a chance to make some bound state. Anyway, this is a brief summary. We have quickly addressed about the XYZ. So anyway, we have several candidates, but the research is still continuous because we have to find more detailed analysis and we have to identify the internal structure. And within the 5 minutes, I want to show some recent results about the heavy hadrons from characteristic heavy hadron regions, which should be interesting to you here. And I'd like to say about the properties of the hadrons from nuclear matter. So, as I have said in the previous study, there is a fundamental question. And here, I'd like to say about the phase diagram and at the finite temperature and the finite density, and in connection to the XYZ. So the problem is, what is the production, or exotic hadrons can be produced or not in the finite region. So this is a little bit rare event, but there is still, we have a chance to see this kind of exotic from the heavy ion regions. And our basic question is, what is the production event? What is the exotic hadrons? And work has been done in 2011 by those groups, which is called EXIT collaboration, although this is a theoretical one, we named the EXIT collaboration. And we use the statistical model as a reference for the production, because statistical model is working very well for a variety of hadrons. And then we also use the fluorescence model to take into account the internal structure of the exotic hadrons. And we construct several candidates. The first candidate is normal step 2-4, in this case TV, and compact chronological, and hadronic one. And we have investigated how much the yield is different for each picture. And here is a list of a table of the results. This is the yield nucleus. And in the statistical model, I have to show something. Statistical model, we have some number, and the quantitative number, we can calculate for 2-4 state, and we also can calculate for the compact chronological state, and we can do the same thing for the hadron model state. So anyway, what is important thing is that the fluorescence model predicts different numbers depending on the internal structure, the compact state, multiple state, and the hadron state. Therefore, in that sense, by measuring the phase experiments, gives us some information about internal structure. And the summary is given like this. So this is the ratio of the fluorescence model and statistical model predictions, and here is the several candidates, including the known hadrons, and also some theoretically predicted hadrons, and the results of this. And this gray band means that the normal hadrons, almost all normal hadrons, like neutron, like proton and pion, within its error bars. So the fluorescence model and statistical model are very consistent with each other. However, then we apply this fluorescence model to the 2-4 state or tetrahedral state and molecule state, we can find some deviations. And if the compact, as for the compact state, the fluorescence model predicts the less yields, because the wave function is very small in the phase space, therefore the probability to find state is very suppressed, therefore the ease becomes less than statistical model. On the other hand, in the hadronic model, the wave function is extended, therefore the correlations model predicts larger number than the statistical model. This is an interesting point. And finally, I'd like to talk about finite density. And here, I'd like to remind you about the nuclear charge. Now, the nuclear charge is extended to the strangeness, as we know, may know. So the nuclear charge is now the three-dimensional. And what I want to do here is to extend further to the charm direction, or bottom, and see the nuclear properties, how the nuclear properties change by including the charm bottom force inside. And what is essentially different from the strangeness or strangeness hypernucleus is that our charm hadron has a very large mass, and it enables easy to make a bound state inside the nucleus. And secondly is the heavy proximity, as we have seen already. And this heavy proximity is a kind of asymmetry which does not exist in the strangeness. In this sense, we can find what we can expect something new would be appear in the hadron nucleus spectroscopy. And indeed, there are many things which should be discussed in this charm and bottom nucleus. And this is my cartoon about what is discussed at the moment. But anyway, what is important thing is that we have three important questions here. The first is to ask the hadron nuclear interaction. This is related to the Weber symmetry, parasymmetry, and heavy proximity. And this is related to our XYZ state, because some XYZ are at the bound state of two hadrons. And to know the hadron interaction is important question. The second question is to ask the properties of hadron medium, because higher symmetry could be partially restored in the nuclear matter. Therefore, the charm hadron should be different from the working one. And the third one is the nuclear structure change, because the heavy hadron is a kind of impurity for the nucleus. In that sense, it could change something about the nucleus property, like spin spin isospin correlation, something. But anyway, what we have to do is just very simple. Just give the interaction between the heavy hadron and nuclear. In this case, the target is the nuclear. And once we have the interaction between heavy hadron and nuclear, we can apply this to the many body problem and see the nuclear medium structure and some surface problems. And of course, to be realistic, we have to research some Peabody system and actually several calculations about the Peabody light nucleus with charm and bottom has been performed so far, like JFCNN, gamma CNN, DNN, DIVA NN, and DNN. Here, I'd like to quote some your attention to this state, because this is interesting in the sense of the heavy spin symmetry. So yesterday, I have talked about the vertex structure of the heavy hooks in heavy hadrons, and which has been given by in terms of the distributed H and the axial current A. And this axial current supplies some interaction between the time coefficient potential between this heavy meson and the nucleus. And here, of course, the heavy hook spin symmetry is a factor in our running. And the result is something like this. So what we have to do is just solve the three body problem, including the fine change, the tensor potential. And we found that, this is the DBNN, and this is the BNN. And we also analyzed the heavy hook limit here. And this is the threshold, this is the threshold. Then we find that the heavy hook spin doublet exists in the 0 minus and 1 minus channel. As I have said yesterday, there is a general structure of the heavy spin symmetry. And this is also true, not only the single hadron, but also for this kind of nucleus structure. And of course, in our real nature, the heavy symmetry is not a perfect one, just it's an approximate symmetry. Therefore, it is partially a group. But still, we can find some pair of states here and here corresponding to this, with here and here. And interestingly, this is a bound state. And that we also have the Hesse-Bach elements of the session. Okay, so this is the end of my story. So this is the summary. Anyway, to proceed more further, I want this XYD to be an interesting subject in other fields. Thank you very much.
So do we have any question?
I think I can speak loud enough. Concerning, for instance, one of the possible explanations.
Which is the hybrid. There is one of the Weissing, I remember, which could be a hybrid. But in theory, there are many hybrids that are there. So where are all the others?
Yeah.
So why do we see, in some cases, only one example of external resonance, but then the theory is much more than what we actually see?
Yeah, I understand. So, yes, theoretically, there are many predictions about this hybrid state. But the problem is that some hybrid has the same quantum number with normal CC bar. So, in that sense, to distinct the two states, the normal CC bar and hybrid, is quite a difficult problem. But I think we need some more quantitative study.
I mean, you have shown this comparison with the coalescence model and statistical model. I wonder how you distinguish between the real hadronic bound states and the molecule in terms of the statistical model. I don't see the difference.
In the statistical model, we cannot see that any difference.
Right, but there is no difference at all.
Yes, if the nature of is only the statistical model, we cannot see any difference. If the nature of is a coalescence model, then we can see. So this is the basis.
And do you understand why this decay to of this x state to psi prime and gamma is larger than to j psi and gamma? This is really quite surprising. Because usually, if you look on all hadronic interactions, the psi prime to j psi ratio is of the order of 0.5. So it's much easier to produce shape side and psi prime.
So in this sense, this is a kind of property of this model because in this model many components are supposed to exist in the detail stuff bar. So in this sense, the dominant contribution is molecule detail, moderate molecule. And shape side component is less in this sense. But this is just a what is this? Sorry, of course. Okay, thank you.
So, is it a short one?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, just when you discussed the ZB resonances and showed the comparison with this data, of course, I'm a theorist, but I have a kind of. I see there's few things, and you fit the two things. So did one try to explain with three? Then you show this spectrum. There's a bit of fantasy, I see three things. So between the...
Okay, this is clear. This
the first is clear, yeah. And then?
This is a little bit unclear in the sense of... Yeah, they claim, of course, in their paper. But this is, I guess, clear. And this is the white transparency a little bit. This is best statistics. So this is by compound.
But from the theory, I mean, would it be conceivable from the model to have an explanation of three neighboring states.
But this, what do you mean by three?
In the middle, there is a point which sticks out. With a bit of fantasy, this would be the peak, yeah? Then you would have three points.
Let's end the discussion here and thank our speaker again. So we'll take 10 minutes here and come back to the PowerPoint.